bachelor right triangle. Does anyone know what are the bachelor right triangles?
Yeah, Jerry.
A special right triangle is a triangle that is special.
Does anyone else know the answer of this question?
There are two types of special right triangles. There's the isosceles and the 30-60-90 triangles.
Yes, you are correct. There are two special right triangles. One is known as the isosceles triangle, which has two sides are equal. This is A, this is A. And the third one is known as like A square root 2. You see the angle 45, it should be equal to this A side. And this one equal to this side. Yes.
Because you're taking the time.
How do you know which side is the hypotenuse?
Yes, the way how we know the hypotenuse is that it is opposite to the 90 degree angle. So this is the hypotenuse because this is opposite to the 90 degree angle. Now I'm going to show you how to solve a hypotenuse in the triangles when we see two angles are same and we should be 45 degree and 45 degree. That this should be 2, this side 2 and this side also 2 because they have 45 degree and they both have the same angle, and let this hypotenuse be x. And now we want to find the hypotenuse. To find the hypotenuse in this way, we can use two formulas. Either way, we can use Pythagorean theorem or we can apply the A square root 2. So first do with the Pythagorean theorem, which we know before, and this is A square plus B square is equal to C square. In this way, this is A, this is B, and this is C. And 2 square plus 2 square is equal to C square. 2 square plus 2 square is equal to 8, is equal to C square. And if we take square root of both sides, it is 2 square root 2 is equal to C, which we already proved, like this side will be the multiplier of square root 2 with this side A. What about if we have hypotenuse and we want to find the both lengths? So I would do that example and I would show you how to solve that. Let this side to be 8, that is hypotenuse, and this is x and this is y. And as we know that this is, these both are same, so we can let this side or any other side, this plus x square plus x square, let this side to be x for some time, and is equal to 8 square. 2x square is equal to 64, and x square is equal to 32. And as we know, we have to solve it to the simplest radical form. So we will take square root, and this is like 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. This is a pair, this is a pair. So x is equal to 4 square root 2. And so just write here 4 square root 2. As we know that this is the same as this. So y is equal to for square root 2. Now we are going over to the another type of special right triangles, which is 30 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree triangle. So this is the shortest angle, 30 degree. So this should be equal to the shortest side, which is A. And this is the medium angle, 60 degree, which should be A square root 3. And this is the largest 90 degree angle, which is 2A. Yes.
How do you know which sides are the legs?
That's a good question. Some people make a common mistake in solving this kind of question. So this is a hypotenuse because this is the opposite of the 90 degree angle, and hypotenuse is always opposite to the 90 degree angle, and these are the legs because these legs are always adjacent to the 90 degree angle. So if we want to know which is the smallest leg and which is the largest leg, we have to know the angle. This is the smallest angle, which is 30 degree, and so this should be the smallest leg, and this is the largest angle than this angle, so this is the largest leg. Now I'm going to show you the example of how to find the legs by knowing the hypotenuse. Let this be the 9. This is the hypotenuse, and we want to find two legs. This is x and this is y. So you know you can't use Pythagorean theorem, because for Pythagorean theorem you have to know the anything like two legs or one leg and one hypotenuse, and this way you have only one thing, which is hypotenuse. And that's where you have to look at these angles, 30 degree and 60 degree. As you know, there is a theorem, 30 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree triangle. So we can apply here. So we know this is A and this is 2A. And this side, which is the largest, this is A square root 3. And in this way, we want to find x. X is equal to 9 divided by 2. So this is x. And now we want to find y. So just plug in the A and multiply by square root 3. So in this way we have x is equal to A. So plug in 9 over 2 square root 3, this is equal to y equal to 9 over 2 square root 3, and that's where you can solve the legs by using the 30 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree theorem. Do you have any question?
Yeah, how can we apply this to real life?
Yes, we can apply that in real life. For example, if we have ladder facing right to the tree, which is 8 feet tall and which is 4 feet apart from the tree, and we want to find the height of the tree. Let this is x, and we know that angle is 90 degrees because this is straight and vertical, and this is 30 degrees. Let's make a triangle like this, and this is 30 degrees because this is facing right to the smallest, and this is 4 feet, and this is 60 degrees, and we want to find the x. Here we can apply the 30 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree triangle theorem, as we know, this is A and this is 2A. 4 multiplied 2 is equal to 8 feet. And we want to find X, which is A square root 3. So in this way, we have A is equal to 4. So we can just plug in 4 square root 3. So the height of the tree should be 4 square root 3 feet. Okay, class. Tomorrow, don't forget, you have a test tomorrow on the two types of special right triangles.